WBAL Radio talk show host Ron Smith today announced publicly that he has pancreatic cancer. It's a disease that's gotten a lot of recent attention because of the death of Apple co-founder Steve Jobs. In this case, Ron says he's going to stay on the air as long as possible. He spoke with our Jane Miller today, and Jane joins us now live from the newsroom with more. Jane?
Rod, as you know, Ron's been part of the WBAL family for most of the past 38 years. He calls what he faces now a journey that his listeners will share.
Usually geared to policy and politics, the Ron Smith Show on WBAL Radio this morning started with something much more personal.
Friday morning at 7:30, I got a call from my beloved friend, Dr. Bill Howard, who said to me, the CAT scan shows that you have a tumor on your pancreas.
What's the prognosis?
Well, here's what I was told by doctors whom I trust not to be BSing me. And that is that this cancer, which is stage 4 pancreatic cancer, metastasized to various organs, that this is very much worth fighting, that with new chemo treatments, that they have quite a bit of success. So I could have many months ahead.
Pancreatic cancer is often without symptoms until later stages, and so it was in Ron's case.
Several weeks ago, I started feeling unwell, sort of vaguely. You know, I get feelings of constipation and migrating pains in the middle of my body.
You also told me that, because you're a golfer, you lost distance your drive.
I did. And, just for reasons that I couldn't explain.
Here's Nick. Hello, Nick. How are you?
Ron says he will stay on the air and share his experience with listeners, might even blog about it, but that won't become the show's focus.
We're going to do the Ron Smith Show. It's going to be like it's been as it has evolved over the years. It's not going to be a pity party. It's not going to be 3 hours about Aunt Gert's tumor, anything of that sort. I'd like to be a help to people, however it would be, through sharing my experiences. I really want to be able to help other people on my way out. That's really it. Now I'm tearing up. I haven't cried at all. And now I'm tearing up just thinking about that. So there you have it.
Dr. Joe Herman, the co-director of the Pancreas Cancer Clinic at Johns Hopkins, who is not involved in Ron's case, told us he applauds Ron's decision to be public about his situation. There's not enough attention, he said, to this particular disease. 36,000 people a year are diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. The 5-year survival rate is less than 5%. Reporting live tonight from the newsroom, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL, TV 11 News.
All right, thank you, Jane. Many of you are sharing get-well wishes for Ron. Sue writes on our Facebook page, "Ron, you can beat this. Prayers are with you and your family. You have such a wonderful personality. You're going to do just fine." And Cynthia writes, "Ron, prayers and good wishes. Get well. Baltimore needs you."
That's true.